Good morning, mighty men. After a retreat of Consecration Friday into Saturday last weekend, our small group of mighty men with Earl and Trish and a partner in ministry, Alan, we ascended the high place of Topeka, Kansas to pray and worship and to make proclamations.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. Thank you for the foundations.
Yes, Jesus.
The foundations of our faith.
Lord, you said, come unto you, and you'll make us white as snow.
Father, we thank you for the dropping of this plumb bot.
Holy, righteous. To hold back their wickedness, destruction.
Not only on the physical earth, but the spiritual place where each one of us has been planted.
That moment by moment, here's what's happening. We're on the summit.
To him, 10,000 times 10,000 stood before him. The court was seated.
Would you join us in unity to intercede for America through the synergy of the ages? In other words, we join our prayers and proclamations with those of our forefathers with the expectation that God is not done with America yet. One of the most important proclamations was the Mayflower Compact, which we will pray this morning. But first, our Bible reading, Revelation chapters 1 through verse 17 of chapter 2. Now, I personally don't believe in a secret rapture, and this following passage is one of the reasons why. Chapter 1, verse 5. To him who loves us and has freed us from our sins by his blood and made us a kingdom, priest to his God and Father, to him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Behold, he is coming with the clouds, and every eye will see him, even those who pierced him, and all tribes of the earth will wail on account of him. Even so, amen. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you for the Mayflower Compact of 400 years ago, which states America was established, quote, for the glory of God and the advancements of the Christian faith. We come into agreement with them as they pledge to, quote, solemnly and mutually in the presence of God and one another, covenant and combine themselves together. They were determined to, quote, enact, constitute, and frame such just and equal laws, ordinances, acts, constitutions, and offices, end quote, that would reach this goal of glorifying you, Lord, and advancing your kingdom. So we say, amen. Let it be so for America. Revive us again to serve you, and as a result, to be a light to the nations, which is our destiny. Prepare us for your coming in the clouds with glory, we pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. If you like this video, click the like button, subscribe, follow, and share. Shalom.